Good morning, students. In the previous video, I explained the difference between respiration and breathing. In this class, we will study about how do we breathe. When we inhale, the air enters through the nostrils into the nasal cavity, or you can say the nasal passage, and then it goes to the windpipe. The air goes to the windpipe, or what is the another name of windpipe? It is also called as trachea. So the air goes into the trachea, into our lungs. And where are the lungs present? The lungs are present in our chest cavity. Okay, you all have studied that chest cavity is surrounded by the ribs, isn't it? On both the sides, you know that the ribs, they cover the chest cavity. You have learned in class 6th also. And what do this, what is the function of this rib? These ribs, this protect the all the delicate organs which are present in our chest cavity, like the lungs, our heart. Okay, they are all protected by the ribs. Okay, now after the ribs, at the floor of the chest cavity is another organ which is called as the diaphragm. Okay, see children, it is diaphragm. Okay, but we pronounce it as diaphragm. G is silent. Okay, it is diaphragm. So what is diaphragm? Diaphragm is a large muscular sheet present at the floor of the chest cavity. Floor of the chest cavity means at the bottom. Okay, at the bottom of the chest cavity there is diaphragm, which is a muscular sheet. And this diaphragm plays a very important role in our breathing procedure. How? I will tell you. Now whenever we inhale, or during inhalation, what happens? This diaphragm, it moves down. Okay, this diaphragm will move down, and when this diaphragm moves down, what will happen? When it is pulling, this diaphragm is pulling, it is moving down. So what will it do? It will pull the ribs also. So the ribs will move outward, and when the ribs come outward, what will happen? A space is created in the chest cavity, and all the air from the nose nostril will rush into the cavity, chest cavity, and your lungs will be full of air, oxygen rich air. Okay, and what happens during exhalation is exactly the opposite. During exhalation, the diaphragm will again come back to its original position. That means wherever it was. First, in inhalation, it had come down. In exhalation, it will come back to its original position. So when it is coming back to its original position, what will it do? It will push the ribs back again to its original position. And when the ribs go back to the original position, what will happen? It is moving inward. And when it is moving inward, all the air, the chest, the size of the chest cavity is reduced, and all the air will be pushed out from the through the trachea out towards to the surrounding. Okay, so this is what is happening. So simply, what do you have to remember? You have to simply remember that during inhalation, the diaphragm moves down, and while moving down, the ribs will come. The ribs will move outward, and when the ribs are moving outward, what will happen? The chest cavity, the space increases in the chest cavity, and all the air will come into the chest cavity. And during exhalation, the diaphragm moves up, or you can say to back to its original position. When it will move back to its original position, it will push the ribs back to its original position. So whatever air is present in the lungs, it will be pushed out. Okay, so this is what is happening during inhalation or exhalation, or we can say this is the process how we breathe. Clear, children? Now our next topic is, what do we breathe out? Okay, and for that we have to do an experiment to find out what do we breathe out. What you have to do, you have to take a slender clean test tube. You can take a test tube or a plastic bottle, and you have to make a hole in the lid and fix it on the bottle. and then pour some freshly prepared lime water in the test tube. Lime water, which lime water? I explained you in chapter 6, isn't it? This lime water is chune ka pani. Okay, this lime water you have to put in the test tube, and then you have to insert a plastic straw through the hole that we made. You had made a hole, na? So in the hole, through the hole, you have to put a straw. And when you put a straw, after putting the straw in the lime water, you have to blow gently through the straw a few times. Now, children, can you tell me what will happen? Will there be a change in the lime water? If you have studied chapter 6, you will be able to answer my question. What happens? I had told you, I had explained you in chapter 6 that whenever you breathe out, or whenever you are exhaling, or whenever carbon dioxide is passed into the lime water, what happens? The lime water always turns milky. Okay, do you remember? Lime water changes into milky. And how does it change milky? Whenever carbon dioxide is passed through it. So in the same way, when you are exhaling, okay, or when you are blowing gently air into it, what will happen? This lime water which was present in the test tube, it will turn milky. So what does this indicate? This indicates that whatever we are breathing out, we are breathing out carbon dioxide. Okay, so do we breathe out only carbon dioxide? No, we do not breathe out only carbon dioxide. There are some mixture of gases also which we breathe out. Okay, a little bit of nitrogen, a little bit of argon gas along with carbon dioxide. And one more thing we breathe out. What do we breathe out? Along with carbon dioxide, in the beginning of the chapter, I had explained you that we also breathe out water in the form of water vapor. Isn't it? That is why you can check it. How can you check it? You can exhale. You can go and stand in front of a mirror. When you go and stand in front of a mirror and if you exhale, what can you see? You can see moisture appearing on its surface. So what does this prove? This proves that we are breathing out carbon dioxide and water vapor. Clear, children? So I hope this much is clear to all of you. Please read the chapter properly. As I told you in the beginning of the chapter itself, that this chapter is totally new to all of you. Okay, so you have to read the chapter and go through the chapter properly. And if you have any queries, you just contact me on my personal number.